Welcome back to my channel, guys. In this video, we are going to be talking about what are the benefits of using titanium in every automobile, including the aerospace technology. So before we start, a science lesson for you all. So tungsten is considered to be the strongest metal naturally found with highest tensile strength. But it's a brittle metal, hence shatters under impact. So because its impact strength is very weak, it's not used as much as titanium in any of the metallic field. Now, when you say titanium, it's a metal that has a highest tensile strength to density ratio of any metal, which makes it stronger than tungsten when you consider strength to weight number. Now, when we talk about the properties of titanium, due to which it's opted in cars and bikes and also in aerospace technology and building aerospace vehicles as well, these are some of the advantages and disadvantages why titanium is becoming more common in the performance oriented machines. The first advantage of using titanium is it's lightweight. Now, taking a GSX-R 1000 Suzuki as an example, exhaust system, it has a catalytic converter, and in titanium full system exhaust, you will not have any cat. So it's not fair to compare the stock exhaust system to the fully titanium exhaust system. So what I am going to do is, to make it fair, I'm going to consider only end cans, only the mufflers. So the stock weight of the muffler is 3.1 kg and the titanium end can weighs 0.695 kg. So when you see the difference, it's almost a 25% of the stock weight. Now, reason being for that is titanium atoms are relatively light and their electron shell is moderately wide, which means fewer atoms can be packed into a fewer volume. So what does this mean is, you can pack least amount of atoms to make it light, though you can produce the required amount of volume of metal. Now, the second reason why titanium is used is because of its anti-corrosion properties. So the scientific reason for its corrosion resistant property is, when titanium is exposed to atmosphere, or any environmental conditions where oxygen is there in the atmosphere, it immediately acquires a thin layer of film of oxide. It is the presence of this layer or the surface film on the metal that is responsible for its excellent corrosion resistance. Now, the third property which makes titanium special is its strength. It's the strongest metal and the highest strength to density ratio of any metallic element on earth. So it's as strong as some of the steel when it is unalloyed, but less dense, which means when it's alloyed, the strength increases significantly as the carbon content will also increase when it is mixed with other metals. The fourth property which makes it special is its thermal properties. Now, it has a melting point of 1650 degrees Celsius. Now, you might compare it to tungsten and tell it that it is almost half of the melting point of the tungsten, which has a melting point of 3422 degrees Celsius. But as I explained you, tungsten is a brittle metal, so it breaks or shatters easily when it is subjected to an impact. It also has fairly low electrical and thermal conductivity, which means it heats less. Even though if titanium heats up, it cools down very quickly as its atomic density is very less. So when you compare the titanium of same volume to that of aluminium, though the aluminium is lighter than titanium, but the strength of the aluminium is not at all even near to titanium's.
6 saal Moscow, paisa barbaad pehencho.
And it also has a lesser melting point around 650 degrees Celsius. So when you compare the same amount of volume of titanium and aluminium, the density of the atoms is way less. So that's what makes titanium so thermal efficient, as it cools down very quickly. Coming to the disadvantages, there are not so many. Now there are only two disadvantages to this metal. So if anything has so many advantages and has some properties unlike to any other metals any of its kind, so it is very expensive. It has a price tag. So if you see the GSXR 1000, which I took as an example, the titanium end can comes at 320 pounds. So when you try to purchase it, it almost comes around 30,000 in Indian currency. But when you import it from other countries, the final price, it's going to be around 60,000, because the custom duty and the GST, everything adds up to a heavy extent. So only the end can cost you around 50 to 60,000. So that's a very, very expensive cost. And if you try to buy a full system exhaust, it's going to at least cost 1.5 lakhs. So in India, you can get a pretty much very good performing 150 to 200cc motorcycle in this price range. The second disadvantage of this metal, which impacts on its cost, is its extraction process. So it doesn't have the same extraction process of some other metals, because it has some special properties, and due to which only specific processes can be used to extract it from its various ores. So that's all with this video, guys. If you have any question, make sure to comment down below.